from 11 to 8. And I'm standing here right in front of you guys today to talk about an effective speech. So I'll be tackling certain topics regarding communication, and I'll also be discussing one, if not some, if not all, communicative strategies as well. So starting off, I want to talk about speeches in general. A speech has three types. It's first is interpersonal, that is between you and yourself, normally used when celebrating. The next one would be interpersonal, that would be you talking to another person or a group of people. The next one would be public speech context, that's what's happening right now, it's the speaker talking to a large amount of people. So what this three has in common is that it has a speaker and its listener, or listeners in my case. And the speaker has to deliver a spoken communication to an audience, which means that the speaker has to convey information to his or her audience. So an effective speech for me is when a speaker conveys his message in the most understandable way. So now I'm going to try to help you in conveying your message in the most effective way by giving you knowledge about nonverbal communication, verbal communication, and communicative strategies. First off the list would be verbal communication. It is spoken or written language in conveying one's message, or the use of sounds and words to express yourself. The elements of verbal communication would be clarity. This refers to correct grammar, short words, specific terms, and short sentences. The next one would be direct and conversational. It is the use of words referring to and involving the speaker and the listener. The next one would be appropriateness. This is the use of appropriate terms depending on the audience. An example of this would be using simpler terms when talking to an audience with toddlers and whatnot. Next would be vivid and impressive. This use of imagery or figurative language. Figures of speech, such as similes, metaphors, personifications, and hyperboles. An example of this would be the all-famous "It's raining cats and dogs." It doesn't really rain cats and dogs, but the meaning it's presenting would be loud. So yeah, moving on. Would be non-verbal communication. Non-verbal communication is the use of vocal and visual elements in conveying one's message. So non-verbal communication has two elements, vocal element and visual element. I would be focusing more on visual element because I think that the first thing that people are going to judge you by is by how you look and the clothes you wear and such. But I believe that visual element is as of equal importance as vocal element. So I'm just going to give a short run-through about vocal element. Vocal element for me, the definition of vocal element for me is the same as the definition of paralanguage. It is the messages that you send with the sound of your voice. So the sound of your voice. When we say the sound of your voice, the first thing that will probably come out of your mind is pitch, the highness or lowness of your voice, the power of your voice or its loudness, and rate, the speed of how you talk. Next, articulation. This is basically pitch, volume, and rate all in one word. Next is pronunciation, the way you pronounce your words. And non-fluencies, the tendencies to put pauses between speeches. It is the unmeaningful words that you put, like on, and whatnot. Moving forward to visual elements. This is the contrary of vocal elements, because instead of instead of the sound of your voice, you're rather focusing on your your physical body, your posture, your eye contact, and your clothing as well. So the visual elements are kinesics. This is study of the body, your posture. Okulesis. This is the study of eye movement, more on eye contact between the audience and the speaker. Next would be proxemics. This is the distance between the speaker and his audience. And haptics, the touching movement, next would be objectives. Objectives. It is the use of physical objects to denote meaning, like my glasses. It may denote that I am smart, even though I'm not. Next would be environmental factors. That is when the physical environment reveals the characteristics of the speaker. So if I would be presenting a speech in, let's say, Quiapo, people won't listen to me because the place says otherwise. So moving on would be physical elements. Clothing, the way you look, and your clothing and the way you look will communicate your status in life. So if you're wearing a sandal, it will probably mean that you're poor, and if you're wearing a suit, it will probably mean you're rich and well to do. So moving on to communicative strategies. These are plans, ways, and means of sharing info which are adopted to achieve a particular social, political, psychological, or linguistic purpose. So I'm just gonna focus on one communicative strategy since I lack the time, and since I'm overdue with my time. So I'm just gonna give a round two to it. Nomination, restriction, topic control, turn taking, shifting, repair, and terminal. So I'm gonna focus on repairing because I believe that we humans are not perfect and we often make mistakes. And with these mistakes, we have to find a solution for it. That's repair. An example of repairing would be repeating yourself, rephrasing what you said, or asking the audience if they get the meaning that you're trying to convey. So if you're interested to know the other communicative strategies, you can research it in www.google.com. Okay, so to summarize my speech, verbal communication is the use of sounds and words to express yourself. Non-verbal communication is the use of vocal and visual elements in conveying one's message. Communicative strategies are ways of sharing info which are adopted to achieve a purpose. So thank you and goodbye.